Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at the new premium per user. This is so exciting. All right, let's dig in. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, Power BI premium per user. What is this? This is essentially a new offering inside of Power BI. Think of this as another license type. Well, it actually is another license type that allows folks to have premium capabilities without actually having an actual premium capacity. So from a license perspective, we've got three licenses now: Power BI Free, Power BI Pro, and now Power BI Premium per user. The big deal about this is just the lower price point, right? This is really targeted for small, medium businesses. Those folks potentially didn't have the capability to purchase a Power BI premium capacity at the price tag that entailed. That was more geared for large enterprise customers. With premium per user, ideally it's going to be a lower price point that allows individuals to actually purchase this and get the capabilities that premium offers. In full disclosure, as of the recording of this video with the public preview, the actual price of premium per user has not been disclosed yet. It's anyone's guess. There was a quote from someone on one of our live streams where they said, "I'm guessing it's going to be between the price of Power BI Pro and a premium P1 SKU." That's probably a good guess. We are in the public preview period, so it's going to be free for everyone. You can opt into the actual trial itself. Talk more about that in a second, and then just perpetually keep that until general availability is available, at which point then you'll have to decide, is that something that you want to pay for? In terms of the differences between premium per user and an actual premium capacity, there is a link, I'll have it down in the description below, for the actual FAQ. And in the FAQ, underneath, there is an actual chart of the difference of features between premium per user and the premium capacity. So the biggest thing that you're probably going to get out of this is the unlimited sharing piece. And we'll touch on that in a little bit in terms of where you're gonna actually encounter that. It is a difference and you need to be aware of it. So how do you get premium per user? This is gonna be a very similar flow to Power BI Pro itself in terms of the trials and then the application of that license itself. Enough of all this talking, let's head over to my machine and actually see what this looks like. All right, we are looking at Power BI. I'm signed in as my main user. And if I go and click on my profile image, you'll actually see that I have premium per user on this account. So I can do everything that I can do with premium per user from a given perspective. So let's head over to a free user. This user is just a free user, doesn't have anything, doesn't have pro, doesn't have anything else. So I can do one of two things to get premium per user. I can click on the image and I can say buy pro now. Hopefully you would also see a try pro now. Let's see what that actually does. I don't want to actually buy, we want to try. So let's go back. If we go to a given workspace, this is for premium per user workspaces. Instead of just the diamond now, you'll see a diamond with the little magnifying glass on it. Or sorry, not a magnet, it looks like a magnifying glass. It's actually a little person icon. So that denotes the premium per user workspace as opposed to just a premium workspace. As a free user, if I go and click on that, I'll get the normal flow that I get for a Power BI Pro trial. But one thing you'll see here in the text, it says upgrade to a premium per user license. So effectively, this is gonna give me the premium per user trial license experience. It's just the same flow that we have for a pro trial. When you go and encounter something that requires premium per user, you're gonna get prompted to either try it or you've got to buy it. You have those choices. Once general availability is out as well, you'll have the same similar trial experience that you had with Power BI Pro, where you can actually go into Office 365 or Microsoft 365 and actually get a trial block there. It'll give you 25 licenses and it'll be good for 30 days. Most folks are probably going to go down the in-service trial where you'll get 60 days and you can get it with inside of the service for each individual. During the public preview, this will allow you to extend that trial. So it'll perpetually allow you to extend it until general availability. So that's how you're going to keep the premium per user for an individual, just ongoing. Once this is in general availability, it'll be a normal license assignment. So you'll see the license block inside of Office 365 or Microsoft 365, and then admins can go ahead and assign that license to a given user. And as it's stated in the FAQ, the premium per user license includes all the capabilities of Pro as well. So you don't need to have Pro and premium per user. You can just have premium per user. All right, let's talk about workspaces, right? Because I mentioned this premium per user workspace. Let's head back to my machine and take a look at that. All right, so I'm back on my main user and I have a workspace already, but let me just go ahead and create a new workspace. And one thing you'll see here is I can assign premium capacity, but this isn't going to let me do this for premium per user on workspace creation. You're going to have to create the workspace first and then assign it to premium per user after the fact. So let's go ahead and save this. And then once I've created the new workspace, then you go into settings, you'll see the premium tab. And when I go to premium, you'll see premium per user in the list. And so we can assign it to there. If you have other capacities, you'll see other capacities listed here, but then you will see premium per user as well. So I can just assign this. I'll get my XMLA endpoint if that's enabled. And then it's just any other workspace. So let's go ahead and hit save. This message calls out the fact that only people with the premium per user license will be able to access this workspace. That's an important piece here. And I mentioned before that there's a big difference here about the unlimited sharing. With premium, if a workspace is assigned to regular premium capacity, anyone can access the content in that workspace, whether it's free, pro, whatever. If you have a premium per user workspace, only folks with that premium per user license will be able to access that content. That's a huge difference, one that you need to understand. This is not something where free users are just going to be able to hit it and get to that content. So just be aware of that, be mindful. Anything where we had that free sharing as part of premium capacity, that does not exist with premium per user. So I'm gonna hit continue, bam. One thing you'll notice here now is I've got my diamond icon with the little person there, not a magnifying glass, a person. And then we can just go ahead and create the workspace as necessary. And I can add folks to this and just take advantage of those capabilities of premium. So AI, paginated reports, model size, all of that. There are some administration pieces of this. If you're familiar with Power BI Premium, you'll know that you had all these capabilities to manage settings of workloads and things of that nature. That doesn't exist with premium per user, but there are a couple of items that the Power BI admins can affect. Let's take a look at that. If we go up to the gear, we go to the admin portal, and then we will see an option here for premium per user preview. And within here, we will see the auto refresh options. We can set minimum refresh interval and minimum execution interval as part of that. When this first came out, Patrick was really interested in this, the XMLA endpoint itself. So we can set it to off, read only, or read write. This is for any premium per user workspace. So it's not just for a specific workspace. So be aware of that. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think of premium per user? Let me know in the comments below and check out the links in the description for more information. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.